Welcome to our exploration of the history of the space shuttle's evolution. Enterprise, a space shuttle that has never been to space. NASA's first space shuttle was designed for atmospheric flight testing only. It never got into space. However, its dimensions were the same as those of the following space shuttles, so that the two-man aerodynamic tests were relevant. The Enterprise space shuttle was also used to check the launch ramp.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Columbia, a shuttle destined for primacy and records. The space shuttle Columbia was the first to fly into orbit and was the last to be destroyed. It was the first to test an unpainted external tank. The Columbia was also the first shuttle to be used repeatedly. Columbia served 28 missions, such as launching the Chandra X-ray telescope.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Challenger, the first crashed space shuttle. Serving 10 missions, the Challenger was the least used out of the space shuttles. It spent a total of 62 days and nearly 8 hours in outer space. This shuttle has a tragic primacy. Shortly after the launch of one mission, the shuttle exploded, killing all 7 astronauts on board.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Discovery, the busiest space shuttle. The space shuttle Discovery went into orbit 39 times, carrying a total of 252 astronauts. It spent 1 year and 22 hours in space. It carried the Hubble telescope and the Ulysses solar probe. It is often referred to as the space shuttle for returning to duty.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Atlantis, the first space shuttle to space station Mir. The space shuttle Atlantis was built as the penultimate model and during its 33 missions orbited Earth 4,848 times. It has a record 7 connection to Mir. This space shuttle closed its entire 30-year shuttle program in 2011 with its last mission.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Endeavour, space shuttle built from spare parts. The last space shuttle was created to replace the destroyed Challenger, and its construction was done with spare parts left over after the construction of the space shuttles Discovery and Atlantis. During the one mission, the crew of the Endeavour carried out the first Hubble telescope service check.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
We'll be right back. What was the space shuttle? The space shuttle was the most complex space vehicle design of its time. We'll explore the key components of the space shuttle. Shuttle, a reusable craft that carries a crew and payload into orbit, performs operations, then re-enters the atmosphere and lands as a glider. External tank, it holds fuel for the shuttle's main engines and provides structural support for the solid rocket boosters and orbiter. It's the only part of the shuttle not reused. Solid rocket boosters. These provide the majority of thrust for liftoff and are the largest solid propellant motors ever flown. They are recovered by ships for reuse. Crew compartment. This is the astronaut's home for the mission. The pressurized cabin has three levels: the upper flight deck, medic living area, and lower equipment bay. Main engines. Three 3-ton engines mounted in a triangle help steer the shuttle for 8.5 minutes until reaching orbit. Nozzle. It directs the thrust of the boosters and steers the shuttle by channeling exhaust. How long was the space shuttle? The space shuttle, including the orbiter and the external fuel tank, had a total length of approximately 56 meters. The most common model of the space shuttle orbiter alone was approximately 37 meters long. NASA developed space shuttles to reduce the cost of travel in space. The ability to use these shuttles repeatedly promised cost savings. The total duration of all shuttles' missions combined was 1322 days, 19 hours, 21 minutes, and 23 seconds. Out of the 135 missions, only two ended tragically. Because there were always more astronauts on board than on board a conventional spacecraft, these tragedies cost the lives of 14 astronauts. Five shuttles, the Columbia, Challenger, Atlantis, Endeavour, and Discovery, did amazing things technically,